thrives on like affiliate costs when he's working. And he proved that over this year, that finding the perfect balance of work and volume is the fittest he's ever been.
I feel like him and I are very similar with that. Like, he can very much use an affiliate class to bring intensity. Yeah.
Plus, 4 weeks is like the perfect amount of time for this.
I'm telling
like,
you.
Adrenaline to just stay with him. So he's like, fucking let's go.
He and you together are like, all he needs to do is grow a mullet because he's going to be like the fucking talk of the CrossFit Games.
Yeah, he needs to be
they got married and now that he married into a Games family, now he qualifies for the game, whatever the hell they're going to say.
And he's going to do really well.
He said you get to supervise him on most of the podcasts? You'll be on them with him? Okay, good.
Two of the three.
You're on with Savon?
No.
Who's going to do
Tommy and Sean Woodland.
Nice.
Clydesdale.
Horse media.
Horse
people.
They're easy to talk
and
to.
And then, I don't know who else.
Misfit podcast.
Honestly, it's probably going to be him supervising me. I'm going to have to.
So you don't get fired up.
Oh, today's a doozy. We got four mock games workouts. They're on day two. We begin with a pretty nasty chipper. I believe 60 calorie bike. For the men, I'm not positive what it's scaled to for the women, but 60 calorie bike, 50 cleans, 126 foot sled drag, so they'll clean inside, advancing every 10, drag that way, go back in, 40 shoulder to overhead, advancing every 10, drag all the way back here, 30 overhead squats, final drag, and then sprint to the finish. Good way to start the day. Nice long chipper.
You got some new friends to throw down with today, huh?
Thank God.
Oh my God.
Bumper's been great, but yeah, he doesn't even know where I am most of the time, so he's currently looking for me.
Very excited to do some workouts with some people.
Yeah, it'll be a lot more fun to do that and have the weekend just be stress-free of distractions and coaching and and really just dial it in for the weekend. So I didn't really ever get like a mock games prep. Like when I came up, I think in 2018, like we did a ton of stuff, but it wasn't like laid out like we're imitating the games. You know what I mean? So like I didn't really get the full like, okay, day three fatigue feel. Like what is that like? What is it like on day four? Can I still push? What's my eating plan? Like all that kind of stuff. So I'm excited to like dial that in and find like what will work and what doesn't, stuff like that. So it'll be fun.
You're in a new division this year, yeah?
I am, but it don't feel like it. Yeah, I thought I'd get some scaling options or anything. Nah, they don't care. There's no respect, you know?
Excited for this weekend?
Yeah, man, it's definitely a change. We're excited because of the weather, you know? We left and it was 106.
Oh.
Yeah, we got here about 60 something. That's beautiful. We got in y'all's cold tub, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
Where's the ice at? It'll be nice. The water here is cold enough in tap. Yeah.
Your only thought in your head is active shoulders. And if you really sit back on these, you're gonna feel super stable and be able to knock out these reps.
It's been good. It's been interesting seeing is just raw capacity and also seeing how much room for improvement there is. So I think just in terms of the consistency and training and approach to pieces, it's like working with somebody who is, you know, this phenomenal athlete, but also still has this sort of beginner mentality because he's open to all these changes. So it's been really fun.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's going to be a fun games, and even looking forward another year, it's going to be really fun.
I swear I coach without a cereal bowl in my hand, too.
I don't believe it.
Yeah, I got two packages of oatmeal, some flaxseed, and two scoops of proper. Just trying to get a little bit of carbs and protein because I don't really do a good job of eating. I like to save, I don't know, 12,000 calories for the evening, and usually that makes me sick. So trying this thing called breakfast. Let me know if you tried it. So Roy's going to go against Mike Kern and the ladies in the chipper event, and the teenagers right afterwards are going to be doing effectively their final because Sophie leaves after this first event. It's been fun to watch them battle back and forth, and they're starting to create, you know, a trading relationship that's, like, I think good for both of their growth.
because when one's good at something, they tell the other one what their score is and they can push for that score and vice versa. So a lot of learning happening here, and you can see them talking about workouts in ways that are different. Like, you're starting to really dig into the athlete IQ.
I love the enthusiasm of the fresh downhill sled.
Oh, is that what that was?
No. No, 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 no. So real quick on the flow of the workout, we have 60 calories. You're going to start at this first cone. Every 10, you advance to the cone. Before you go do the sled, you roll forward to get into that spot. With the sled itself, it's barely enough room to get the full distance, so you're gonna pull until your feet are past the cone. And then in the opposite direction, whatever slack you get, you're gonna add in terms of walking back into the gym. So you will have that one round where you have to run all the way down to the other side. For the final round, once you guys are doing your overhead squats, we'll position your sleds for you and tell you where to go. Most out of training with each other this weekend, you have to pretend it's one way while you're training and then a different way after. So like really try to compete with each other while you're going, just so you know what that feels like. And then afterwards, pretend like you were just on a two-person team. Break down everything that you did. What did you hold for wattage? What were your sets? Try to beat each other and then try to like really strategize together afterwards.
We're pretty good at that.
Yep.
I was an ass kicking.
Yeah.
Definitely a higher level intensity here. Yeah, it was good. It's what I needed. Remotely, me and LaSalle go head to head quite a bit, but not in the gym as often. So this is good going competition setting, chasing, being chased.
I am going to have you both start like back behind the rig and just run to the rope for the very, very first one.
Need this little energy coming down the rope without honestly free falling from the top so that we can go into the double unders and be calm and then move to that dumbbell side.
What you've been doing in terms of chunking, right? Take the moment you're on and focus on the next rep. Only the next rep. Don't worry about the whole workout. You do very well in your workouts, believe it or not. Which means you are fit.
I know,
even
crazy.
Even though you don't like to think that you're fit and that you just lift weights, like, this is an expression of fitness too.
I've been playing this like 30 in a row.
How long did that take us?
I will try to do the same weight as them at lunch, and I will do it slower than them almost certainly.
That was a double under workout for me. Cool. But I mean, it was a lot of double unders compared to the time of the other movements.
That's your last workout for the weekend? Here, at least?
Yeah.
Around the house. I can't wait to get my jersey back up there.
Back up there? I don't think we took it down.
I know, but my set, like, my...
He doesn't have this
third one.
You don't have a noble one.
Yeah, I don't have a noble one.
You need the noble jersey.
That was a long chipper, so Gabe was like, see if you can hold higher on the bike and see what it does to the rest of the workout. So I think I learned a little bit of, like, I get off the bike almost a minute before Caroline did, but she caught me, like, in the middle of the workout. So just going out a little too hot. So, but it's good to know those things. It was... a beefy workout, but it felt good.
How many more do you have today?
Three more.
Beefy day.
It was a beefy day. But again, it's good to be up here. Like, I can't say that enough, you know? So I'm excited. I wish the teens were doing some of the same stuff, but I like watching them. So the Sabatinis, they have a lake. Their aunt and uncle have a lake house. So normally for all of our workouts, we'll go up there. But little Sabatini, Caroline Sabatini, qualified in the 14-15s.
Oh
yeah, so she wanted to
we wanted to get her out in the lake and experience it because she's been swimming in the pool so much. Have you guys been getting in the pool at all?
Yeah. I've been swimming, I think, like just once a week. But before water polo, I was doing two.
Yeah.
But I just haven't really. Sherrod wants me to also do math and stuff, so.
Math and swimming in the same day. That's crazy.
Isn't it funny, like, you look back on this, like, afterwards, and you're like, how did I do this, all in one day, and I'm still alive? I don't know how.
I don't think I am.
It's
crazy.
It's
the place to go. It's
been great this weekend.
I hope you're sooner than we know.
Yeah. Man. There's a lot more work after the ring muscle ups. Do it! She probably will. She probably will be, maybe.
Yeah, I'm gonna do them by feel. So it's gonna be like all how my kip and dip feel.
It'll
be 2 or 3 sets. It will! Unless they're feeling like I'm floating like a butterfly, which probably not the case.
I don't believe you.
It will be, I was thinking like 9-6 or 10-5, or I'm going to go 3 sets of like 7-4-4 or something like that so that I can get to the handstand push-ups and not feel terrible.
Have everybody go directly behind their rings, and then we'll start on that side for the handstand one.
Okay. What's
so you two should be close 50? To each other. What's that?
Is that distance 50?
Yeah. A little, but try not to treat it as a break.
Yeah.
Like try to kick, right just up. Kick right back up, and like treat it as if it was a football field, and like, oh, I need to come down.
You want this one?
No. Gonna observe and get some work done between exercise events. I do just enough of them to get a feel for whether we hit the mark programming wise or something comes up short. So I try to either, whether it's the Hatcher version, the MFT version, or somewhere in between. That's how I best learn about whether we fucked it up or if we hit the mark with the workouts. But so far so good.
Definitely a, like, get your 10-second sprint on a machine or something before burpees, whatever, just so that first time you're like, whoa, this actually is still conditioning. You're not surprised. Absolute best gymnast in CrossFit should be able to do this unbroken and have the stimulus of each one feel similar enough. So, like, we're not 100% sure. It's really, to me, the handstand push-ups that are the biggest question. But I also think that those would be the biggest question from athlete to athlete.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
It could get modified, but this is, like, the Misfit gymnastics test.
All right. I'll probably just go by feel then on the first set.
Yep.
Try to go 9 or 10.
Yeah.
Okay.
More than 8.
Okay. I feel like I'm already, like, just swinging all over the place. I don't know why.
No, you can fix that. You're on a bike right now, so you can't swing on a bike.
You might warm up today.
Stand by. Go!
I'm not a kid, 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 I'
bitch. I was like, shit, you ain't gonna spit. I'm scary, I got a gun in this bitch. Smoking on, stop playing, I'm that guy.
Everyone baited for the unbroken.
Oh my god.
That's what I meant. Like, you didn't want to come down for those.
No, I didn't.
I saw you, like.
Well, we were talking about it.
I think she didn't come down because you didn't come down.
Well, I said it too. I was like, unbroken. I think I baited her early on and put it in her head.
Yeah.
But we do, like, her and I are really good with that. We're like, if she sees my score and was like, oh, well, I did this unbroken,
yeah,
I know you can do it too. You know what I mean? So
right.
It's like,
yeah.
Or I know I can do it too if she did it. So it's a benefit. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Those 15 muscle ups, though, probably looked like I had no idea what I was fucking doing. I was all
honestly,
over the place.
It actually looked like, almost like if someone was in a hurricane and they didn't notice they were. Because your body language, you didn't seem to care. But you were fucking...
Just... I had to keep going.
Yeah.
If I stopped to try to, like, you two, like, to fix, it wasn't going to come through.
Yeah, that's
going
to make it a little video. Everyone doing the muscles unbroken.
Yeah, he's going to the games with us.
And,
you know how the fans get to compete,
yeah,
like sign up and do something. That was his motivation for this year to get it.
So he's like,
there you go.
15. Stupid.
Spectator WOD training.
Yes, yeah. So he wants to go crush those now. Yeah. But he's been training. This is his like fourth CrossFit workout. Yeah.
Nice.
Bye, Dad.
Bye.
Love you.
Hi, how are you?
Good.
Are you picking up the puppy right now?
Yeah. Oh, she just made me walk a mile and a half.
Yeah.
Yeah. Sort
of. His dad
did some behind the neck trick presses in there. You doing this one?
Thinking about it.
You snatch 185
flips? I don't think so, that's the problem. I got plenty of snatches this morning.
You did? Doing what?
Or it's squats. You do a lot of sets. That's a lot of snatches.
You want some help?
Son, use your legs. Good lockout, Mo. Get all the way. There you go. There you go.
Solid.
Out of here!
I'll send you all the emojis after my workouts.
Yeah, I learned I can't use the punctuation period anymore. It means
you
I'm
can't.
Too serious or angry.
Do you
so
do
I told
that?
Her now I'm gonna write the
an exclamation point.
Yeah.
I'm gonna write the word period instead. So I'm gonna end every sentence with the word period instead of the. The actual.
No, because you also don't use it like every time. So sometimes Sherb like doesn't put a period after his like sentence, and I'm like, oh god. But when, like,
we're reading a lot more into these conversations than I am. I was like, this, and then period. It's like, it means business. It's like,
yeah.
It's like it means business. I'm like.
Just no periods means you're happy.
Should I go? We're gonna go lowercase and no punctuation and only emojis from now on. So.
Yeah. Need lots of hard eyes. And
yeah, that sounds like me.
Yeah.
That sounds like me.
And it'll be there by the time you get to work.
Okay.
And then 200 afterward.
And I remember I was so jittery when I was out there. So my second attempt, I was at 215. And I was like, okay, so our signal is either going to be one or two for like 5 or 10 pounds. And he's like way up in the bleachers. And I was like, and I stood it up and he's like, and I'm like, no, I don't know if I feel ready for it.
You okay?
Fucking hurt. Christ.
How's your butt?
Holy shit, I cried.
I literally cried.
It was so hard that like I immediately thought I was gonna throw up type of feeling. I could be bleeding, I don't know. Wow.
I did that once on bare skin. I had like a...
You're naked?
Literally like, well, I had shorts on and it was literally like right up my thigh. And it's like,
I'm known in a noble. Yeah. She got an alarm set at 2:30 a.m.
It's out of bed, she does double unders.
Heavy double unders.
Dude. First time, like I've only hit 185 once in my life, so that was second and third. Yeah, so that's a nice little boost. Put a lot of work on it. So
this will be my fifth game, and you know, it takes 10 years into CrossFit. So yeah. This point, just try to stay healthy and healthy. Yeah. But yeah, keep making gains, stay healthy, pick your battles, listen to your body. Yeah, good change this year. Get my ass kicked on training. It's good. It's good.
Hey. What's the deal?
What's the word? Rope climbs and burpees?
Isn't there snatches too?
What's that?
Aren't there snatches too?
There was a couple hours ago.
Oh, I missed the fun one?
Yeah.
I thought it was rope climbs and snatches. Shit.
It's rope climbs and burpee box jump overs.
I think he rested like 15 minutes after this one.
He could do that.
I've been up since 4 a.m. I need one piece.
Just shift everything 5 minutes, so you guys start warming up at 5:10.
Okay. And then when she called me, I was on speakerphone, and it took me a minute to like understand what was happening.
Yeah.
She
was like, no, this is a joke.
Like, this isn't real.
Yeah, there's still moments where I'm like, this is still like, something's gonna go wrong. Like, I had two missed calls from Denver, Colorado today at work. And I was like, fuck, they're calling me to like tell me that I'm not going or something. And then I was working, so I couldn't call back. And they left a voicemail, and it was actually somebody asking for tree work from Denver, Colorado. And I was like, oh my God. I literally didn't believe it. I was like confused, and because I just didn't think there was any chance in hell that somebody would pop. Yeah. Like it's pretty rare, especially for like an individual athlete. Like it doesn't happen that often.
You get your shirt on the wall before Luca.
Ah, suck it, Luca.
No. Get him while he's down, man.
He was the first to talk shit, yeah. So
oh,
it's all good. No, he sent me a message yesterday and was just like stoked for me.
Yeah,
so awesome. It's all good.
Red Bull, nice.
It's Red Bull 40.
Let's get that sponsorship.
Next time, give me a heads up. I'll make a better face. Gatorade.
Yeah.
My proper fuel.
Walkley, come up to the first delay. Pause. Be there and go.
Yeah.
Reset.
I'm a CrossFit.
No.
Caroline Roy off your
face. Shit.
I've been working all day. I don't know what
I've been working all day.
I said CrossFit.
You said, does that stand for something? CrossFit?
What was the R?
You are so smart.
Recovery. Attack. And then poop.
No more warming up in 1 minute.
No!
not warm up right now. It's too much time.
So much time. It's one of those events where it's like, you don't really need to do all that much, like movement, priming, and activation, and stuff, things and stuff. So like, there's a lot of this. I just want to get it over with.
We've achieved games level boredom.
Yeah, that's great.
I got the eye roll I was searching for today. Finally.
Austin doesn't know about it yet. Doesn't know about that sitting around on the floor.
He's just gonna play his boy.
His boy game. Those are the right words.
Is your boy game charged?
What? You charge your boy game?
The boy game.
If you're wondering if you're gonna get like, there's a few seconds left, you're gonna get like two or three, you push for that, get the extra one. Always try to grab that extra one at the buzzer, no matter how fast you have to go for
that. That makes more sense now that I know that there's rest. Stupid idiot.
This is a replay of the 2021 CrossFit Games. Chillin'. Did you think to yourself that you get an elite coach's pass now? Did that pop into your head yet?
Oh, kids back.
Yeah. First thing he thought of.
Yeah.
Fuck yeah, I was like, back. Fuck.
I'm not going to Madison this year.
Sure, if you lost
don't
your
don't
coaching
touch my
side.
Weenus. Don't fucking touch my weenus.
It's awesome.
Touch mine and touch your own. Feel
not there. Rubbing weenuses for Carol 2022. Rubbing weenuses since 2013.
The goal, and now I'm just gonna do what I can do. See what happens.
That's the hard part, is like when you're there, is staying present and like feeling each event and each emotion that you go through. Like that's my like internal goal this year, is to like focus, like be there for all of those things, you know? Yeah, like half the time you do an event and you look back on it, you're like, I don't know what happened. I don't remember.
We'll start behind your box.
Wow, that rope's really grippy.
Same amount of reps, really send the end. Still 30 for time. 3, 2, 1, go!
I feel like I'm not like
hate these ropes though.
A lot more burpee time.
That's true.
Song. Cool down police are in the house. Cool down police, parentheses, are in the house.
Woo, woo, woo. Someone, please.
Every interval was like an all-out sprint, and it was, they ran out of time, not steam. It means we're giving them some good threshold work. They can keep doing that minute on, minute off.
I love that. That was a really good piece, though.
After
that was
the
hard.
First rest, Caroline's face is like, what? It just happened. I was like, that's his piece. Felt that way too.
Walk past if you want to go.
Well, I didn't expect for you and I to go synchro. And like, so I had to keep your pace, otherwise I'm a loser.
I hope all the game sprinting workouts are that possible.
They definitely are.
So far you've had an hour and 15 minute workout and then a short interval.
So is it confirmed that swimming is in a pool this year?
Not
or was that like a rumor?
Yeah, I wouldn't say it's confirmed.
They made a post of a guy at the University of Florida.
It looks like he's testing a workout.
Yeah.
Okay.
I think he's one of the guys that does like the demo photos for like the open.
Yeah.
I think you guys should do both. And I think we need to get some like diving. Like if they're doing a workout where you're on the side of the pool,
yeah.
You need to know how to like maximize jumping in. And,
what if it's a food test and not a swim test?
Oh.
What
you guys would get a rush.
A food test.
A swoop? So no swoop is you kick. This is when you're drinking at a pool. You kick and see how far you can get. And then when that gets boring, you go one swoop.
Oh.
See how far you can get. So you're going.
I'm literally the worst at holding my breath.
You're going meat missile, just like, come on!
We did that at like regionals or semifinals or something, and I was terrible at it.
You just would launch up, holding your breath for 7 seconds, you're panicking.
Literally, like, was the worst of the whole group that was there.
That's it. Day two of Mont Games in the books. Tomorrow is, dare I say, fun.
Ooh, I thought today was fun.
I did one workout.
One workout.
By his standard, tomorrow's not fun. That ski thruster is...
No, that sounds terrible, but pegboard one sounds fun.
Yep. And then heavy clean and jerks. Sunday is very much CrossFit, stacked on CrossFit, stacked on CrossFit, which is how they always end the games. So